Chapter 3 Plant Kingdom. In the previous chapter, we looked at the broad classification of living organism under the system proposed by Whittaker 1969, wherein he suggested the five kingdom classification by Monera, Protista, Fungi, Animalia, and Plantae. In this chapter, we will deal in detail with further classification within kingdom Plantae, popularly known as the plant kingdom. We must stress here that our understanding of the plant kingdom has changed over time. Fungi and members of the Monera and Protista have cell wall have now been excluded from Plantae, though earlier classification placed them in the same kingdom. So, the cyanobacteria that are also referred to as blue-green algae are not algae anymore. In this chapter, we will describe algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm, and angiosperms under Plantae. Let us also look at classification within angiosperms to understand some of the concerns that influence the classification system. The earliest system of classification used only gross superficial morphological characters such as habit, color, number, and shape of the leaves, etc. They were based mainly on vegetative characters or on the androecium structure system given by Linnaeus. Such systems were artificial. They separate the closely related species since they were based on a few characteristics. Also, the artificial system gave equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics. This is not acceptable since we know that often the vegetative characters are more easily affected by the environment. As against this, natural classification systems developed, which were based on natural affinities among the organism and consider not only the external features but also internal features like ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology, and phytochemistry. Such a classification for flowering plants were given by George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. At present, phylogenetic classification system based on evolutionary relationships between the various organisms are acceptable. This assumes that organisms belonging to the same taxa have a common ancestor. We now use information from many other sources too to help resolve difficulties in classification. These become more important when there is no supporting fossil evidence. Numerical taxonomy, which is now easily carried out using computers, is based on all observable characteristics. Number and codes are assigned to all the characters and the data is then processed. In this way, each character is given equal importance and at the same time, hundreds of characters can be considered. Cytotaxonomy, that is based on cytological information like chromosome number, structure, behavior, and chemotaxonomy, that uses the chemical constituent of the plant to resolve confusion, are also used by taxonomists these days. 3.1 Algae. Algae are chlorophyll-bearing, simple, thalloid, autotrophic, and largely aquatic, both freshwater and marine organism. They occur in a variety of other habitats, moist stone soils, and wood. Some of them also occur in association with fungi, lichens, an animal example on sloth bear. The form and size of algae is highly variable, ranging from colonial form like Volvox and the filamentous form like Eulothrix and Spirogyra, figure 3.1. A few of the marine forms such as kelps form the massive plant bodies. The algae reproduce by vegetative, asexual and sexual methods. Vegetative reproduction is by fragmentation. Each fragment develops into a thallus. Asexual reproduction is by the production of different types of spores, the most common being the zoospore. They are flagellated, motile, and on germination give rise to new plants. Sexual reproduction takes place through fusion of two gametes. These gametes can be flagellated and similar in size as in Eulothrix and or non-flagellated, non-motile but similar in size as in Spirogyra. Such reproduction is called isogamous. Fusion of two gametes dissimilar in size as in a species of Eudorina is termed as an isogamous. Fusion between one large fusion between one large non-motile static female gamete and a smaller motile male gamete is termed oogamous. Example, Volvox fucus. Algae are useful to man in variety of ways. At least a half of the total carbon dioxide fixation on earth is carried out by algae through photosynthesis. Being photosynthetic, they increase the level of dissolved oxygen in their immediate environment. They are of paramount importance as primary producers of energy-rich compound which form the basis of the food cycle of all the aquatic animals. Many species of porphyra, laminaria and sargassum are among the 70 species of marine algae used as food. Certain marine brown and red algae produce large amount of hydrocolloids, water-holding substances, example, algin, brown algae and carrageen, red algae, which are used commercially. Agar on the commercial products obtained from gelatium and glaciaria are used to grow microbes and in the preparation of ice creams and jellies. Chlorella, a unicellular alga rich in protein, used as a food supplement even by space travelers. The algae is divided into three main classes, chlorophyaceae, phaeophyaceae and rhodophyaceae. 3.1.1 Chlorophyaceae. The members of Chlorophyaceae are commonly called green algae. The plant body may be unicellular, colonial or filamentous. They are usually grass green due to the dominance of pigment chlorophyll A and B. The pigments are localized in definite chloroplast. The chloroplast may be discoid, plate-like, reticulate, cup-shaped, spiral or ribbon-shaped in different species. Most of the member have one or more storage bodies called pyrenoids located in the chloroplast. Pyrenoid contain protein besides starch. Some algae may store food in the form of oil droplets. Green algae usually have a rigid cell wall made up of an inner layer of cellulose and an outer layer of pectose. Vegetative reproduction usually takes place by fragmentation or by the formation of different types of spores. Asexual reproduction is by flagellated zoospore produced in zoosporangia. The sexual reproduction show considerable variation in the type and formation of sex cells and it may be isogamous, anisogamous or oogamous. Some commonly found green algae are Chlamydomonas, Volvox, Eulothrix, Pyrogyra and Cara. Figure 3.1a. 3.1.2 Phaeophyaceae. The members of Phaeophyaceae or brown algae are found primarily in marine habitats. They show greater variation in size and form. They range from simple branched filamentous form ectocarpus to profusely branched form as represented by kelps, which may reach a height of 100 meters. They possess chlorophyll A, C, carotenoids and xanthophylls. They may vary in color from olive green to various shades of brown depending upon the amount of xanthophyll pigment fucoxanthine present in them. Food is stored as complex carbohydrate which may be in the form of laminarin or mannitol. The vegetative cells have a cellulosic wall usually covered on the outer surface outside by the gelatinous coating of algin. The protoplast contain in addition to plastid a centrally located vacuole and nucleus. The plant body is usually attached to the substratum by the holdfast and has a stalk, the stipe and the leaf-like photosynthetic organ, the frond. Vegetative reproduction takes place by fragmentation. Asexual reproduction in most brown algae is by biflagellated zoospores that are pear-shaped and have two unequally laterally attached flagella. Sexual reproduction may be isogamous, anisogamous or oogamous. Union of gametes may take place in water or within the oogonium oogamous species. The gametes are pyriform, pear-shaped and bear two laterally attached flagella. The common forms are Ectocarpus, Dictyota, Laminaria, Sargassum and Fucus. 3.1.3 Rhodophyaceae. The members of Rhodophyaceae are commonly called as red algae because of the predominance of red pigment, R-phycoerythrin, in their body. Majority of the red algae are marine with greater concentration found in warmer areas. They occur in both well-lighted regions close to the surface of water and also at a great depth in ocean where relatively little light penetrates. The red thalli of most of the red algae are multicellular. Some of them have complex body organization. The food is stored as the fluorodeine starch, which is very similar to amylopectin and glycogen in structure. The red algae usually reproduce vegetatively by fragmentation. They reproduce asexually by non-motile spores and sexually by non-motile gametes. Sexual reproduction is oogamous and accompanied by complex post-fertilization development. The common members are Polysiphonia, Porphyra, figure 3.1c, Glacillaria and Gelidium. Table 3.1, division of algae and their main characteristics. Class, common name, major pigment, food, stored food, cell wall, flagellar, number and position of insertion, habitat. Class, Chlorophyaceae, common name, green algae, major pigment, chlorophyll AB, stored food, starch, cell wall, cellulose, flagellar number and position of insertion 2 to 8 equal and apical, habitat freshwater, brackish water, salt water. Class Phaeophyaceae, common name brown algae, major pigment chlorophyll AC, fucoxanthin, stored food mannitol, laminarin, cell wall, cellulose and algin, flagellar number and position of insertion 2, unequal, lateral, habitat freshwater, rare, brackish water and salt water. Class Rhodophyaceae, common name red algae, major pigment chlorophyll AD, phycoerythrin, stored food fluorodeine starch, cell wall cellulose, pectin and polysulfate esters. Flagella absent. Habitat fresh water some, brackish water, salt water most. 3.2 Bryophytes. Bryophytes include the various mosses and liverworts that are found commonly growing in moist shaded areas in the hills. Figure 3.2. Bryophytes are also called amphibians of the plant kingdom because these plants can live in soil but are dependent on water for sexual reproduction. They usually occur in damp, humid and shaded localities. They play an important role in plant succession on bare rocks or soil. The plant body of bryophyte is more differentiated than that of algae. They are thallus-like and prostrate or erect and attached to the substratum by unicellular or multicellular rhizoid. They lack true roots, stem and leaves. They may possess root-like, leaf-like, stem-like structures. The main plant body of bryophyte is haploid. It produces gametes, hence is called the gametophyte. The sex organ in bryophyte are multicellular. The male sex organ is called antheridium. They produce biflagellated antherozoid. The female sex organ called archegonium is flask-shaped and produce a single egg. Antherozoids are released in water where they come in contact with the archegonium. Antherozoid fuse with the egg to produce the zygote. Zygote do not undergo reduction division immediately. They produce a multicellular body called sporophyte. The sporophyte is not free living but attached to the photosynthetic gametophyte and derived nourishment from it. Some cells of the sporophyte undergo reduction division, meiosis, to produce the haploid spores. These spores germinate to produce gametes. Bryophyte in general are of little economic importance, but some mosses provide food for the herbaceous animals, birds and other animals. Species of sphagnum, a moss, provide peat that have long been used as fuel and as a packing material for the transshipment of living material because of their capacity to hold water. Mosses along with lichens are the first to colonize the rocks and hence are of great ecological importance. They decompose rocks making the substrate soft for the growth of higher plants. Since mosses form the dense mat on the soil, they reduce the impact of falling rain and prevent soil erosion. The bryophytes are divided into liverworts and mosses.
2.1 Liverworts. The liverworts grow usually in moist, shady habitats such as banks of streams, marshy grounds, damp soil, bark of trees and deep in the woods. The plant body of liverwort is thalloid, example Marchantia. The thalloid is dorsiventral and closely appressed to the substrate. The leafy members have tiny leaf-like appendages in two rows on the stem-like structure. Asexual reproduction in liverworts takes place by fragmentation of thalli or by the formation of specialized structure called gamete, single gamma. Gamete are green, multicellular, asexual buds which develop in small receptacles called gamma cups located on the thalli. The gamete become detached from the parent body and germinate to form new individuals. During sexual reproduction, male and female sex organs are produced either on the same or on a different thalli. The sporophyte is differentiated into a food seta and capsule. After meiosis, spores are produced within the capsule. These spores germinate to form free-living gametophytes. 3.2.2 Mosses. The predominant stage of the life cycle of a moss is the gametophyte, which consists of two stages. The first stage is the protonema stage, which develops directly from a spore. It is creeping, green, branched and frequently filamentous stage. The second stage is the leafy stage, which develops from the secondary protonema as a lateral bud. They consist of upright cylinder axis bearing spirally arranged leaves. They are attached to the soil through multicellular and branched rhizoids. This stage bear the sex organs. Vegetative reproduction in mosses is by fragmentation and budding in the secondary protonema. In sexual reproduction, the sex organs Antheridia and Archegonia are produced at the apex of the leafy shoot. After fertilization, the zygotes develop into a sporophyte consisting of food seta and capsule. The sporophytes in mosses is more elaborate than that in liverworts. The capsule contains spores. Spores are formed after meiosis. The mosses have an elaborate mechanism of spore dispersal. Common example of mosses are Funaria, Polytrichum and Sphaginum. Figure 3.2. 3.3 Pteridophytes. The pteridophytes include horsetail and ferns. Pteridophytes are usually for medicinal purpose and as soil binders. They are also frequently grown as ornamentals. Evolutionarily, they are the first terrestrial plant to possess vascular tissue, xylem and phloem. You shall study more about these tissues in chapter 6. The pteridophytes are found in cool, damp, shady places though some may flourish well in sandy soil conditions. You may recall that in bryophyte, the dominant phase in the life cycle is the gametophytic plant body. However, in pteridophytes, the main plant body is a sporophyte, which is differentiated into true roots, stems and leaves. Figure 3.3. These organs possess well-differentiated vascular tissue. The leaves in pteridophyta are small microphylls and as in Selaginella or large macrophylls as in ferns. The sporophytes bear sporangia that are subtended by leaf-like appendages called sporophylls. In some cases, sporophylls may form distinct compact structure called strobili or cones, Selaginella equisetum. The sporangia produce spores by meiosis in spore mother cells. The spores germinate to give rise to inconspicuous, small but multicellular, free-living, mostly photosynthetic thalloid gametophytes called prothallus. These gametophytes require cool, damp, shady places to grow. Because of this specific restricted requirement and the need for water for fertilization, the spread of living pteridophyte is limited and restricted to narrow geographical regions. The gametophytes bear male and female sex organs called Antheridia and Archegonia respectively. Water is required for transfer of entherozoids, the male gamete released from the Antheridia to the mouth of Archegonium. Fusion of male gamete with the egg present in the Archegonium result in the formation of zygote. Zygote therefore produce a multicellular, well-differentiated sporophyte, which is the dominant phase of the pteridophytes. In majority of pteridophyte, all the spores are of similar kinds. Such plants are called homosporous. Genera like Selaginella and Salvinia, which produce two kinds of spores, macro, large and micro, small spores are known as heterosporous. The megaspore and microspore germinate and give rise to female and male gametophytes respectively. The female gametophyte in these plants are retained on the parent sporophyte for variable period. The development of zygote into young embryos takes place within the female gametophytes. This event is a precursor to the seed habit, considered as an important step in evolution. The pteridophytes are further classified into four classes: Coelopsida, Coelotum, Lycopsida, Selaginella, Lycopodium, Sphenopsida, Equisetum, and Pteropsida, Dryopteris, Pteris, and Adiantum. 3.4. Gymnosperms. The gymnosperm, gymnos, naked, sperma, seeds are plant in which the ovules are not enclosed by any ovary wall and remain exposed both before and after fertilization. The seeds that develop post-fertilization are not covered, that is, are naked. Gymnosperm include medium-sized trees or tall trees and shrubs. Figure 3.4. One of the gymnosperm, the giant redwood tree, sequoia, is one of the tallest tree species. The roots are generally taproot. Roots in some genera have fungal association in the form of mycorrhiza, pinus, while in some others, cycas, small specialized root called coralloid roots, are associated with nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. The stem are unbranched, cycas, or branched, pinus, cedrus. The leaves may be simple or compound. In cycas, the pinnate leaf persists for a few years. The leaves in gymnosperms are well adapted to withstand extreme of temperature, humidity, and wind. In conifers, the needle-like leaves reduce the surface area. Their thick cuticle and sunken stomata also help to reduce the water loss. The gymnosperms are heterosporous. They produce haploid microspores and megaspores. The two kinds of spores are produced within sporangia that are born on sporophyll, which are arranged spirally along an axis to form a lax or compact strobili or cones. The strobili bearing microsporophylls and microsporangia are called microsporangiate or male strobili. The microspore develop into a male gametophytic generation, which is highly reduced and is confined to only a limited number of cells. This reduced gametophyte is called a pollen grain. The development of pollen grain takes place within the microsporangia. The cones bearing megasporophylls with ovules or megasporangia are called megasporangiate or female strobili. The male or female cones or strobili may be born on the same tree, pinus. However, in cycas, male cones and megasporophyll are born on different trees. The megaspore mother cell is differentiated from one of the cell of the nucellus. The nucellus is protected by envelope and the composite structure is called ovule. The ovules are born on megasporophyll, which may be clustered to form the female cones. The megaspore mother cell divide meiotically to form four megaspores. I am repeating it once again. The megaspore mother cell divide meiotically to form four megaspores. One of the megaspore enclosed within the megasporangium develops into a multicellular female gametophyte that bear two or more archegonia or female sex organs. The multicellular female gametophyte is also retained within megasporangium. Unlike bryophytes and pteridophytes in gymnosperm, the male and a female gametophyte do not have an independent free-living existence. They remain within the sporangia, retained on the sporophyte. The pollen grains is released from the microsporangium. They are carried in air currents and come in contact with the opening of the ovule born on megasporophyll. The pollen grain carrying the male gametes grow towards archegonia in the ovule and discharge their content near the mouth of the archegonia. Following fertilization, zygote develop into an embryo and the ovules into seed. These seeds are not covered. 3.5. Angiosperms. Unlike the gymnosperm, where the ovules are naked, in the angiosperm or flowering plant, the pollen grains and the ovule are developed in specialized structure called flowers. In angiosperm, the seeds are enclosed in fruits. The angiosperms are an exceptionally large group of plants occurring in a wide range of habitats. They range in size from the smallest Wolfia to the largest tree of eucalyptus over 100 meters. They provide us with food, fodder, fuel, medicine, and several other commercially important products. They are divided into two classes, the dicotyledons and the monocotyledons. Figure 3.5. The dicotyledons are characterized by seeds having two cotyledon, reticulate venation in leaves, and tetramerous or pentamerous flower that is having four or five members in each floral whorls. The monocotyledons, on the other hand, are characterized by the single cotyledonous seed, parallel venation in leaves, and trimerous flower having three members in each floral whorl. The male sex organ in a flower is the stamen. Each stamen consists of cylinder filament with an anther at the tip. Within the anther, the pollen mother cell divide by meiosis to produce microspores which mature into pollen grains. The female sex organ in the flower is the pistil. Pistil consists of a swollen ovary at its base, a long cylinder style and stigma. Inside the ovary, ovules are present. Generally, each ovule has a megaspore mother cell that undergoes meiosis to form four haploid megaspores. Three of them degenerate and one divide to form embryo sac. Each embryo sac has a three-celled egg apparatus, one egg cell and two synergids, three antipodal cells and two polar nuclei. The polar nuclei eventually fuse to produce a diploid secondary nucleus. Pollen grain, after dispersal from the anther, are carried by wind or various other agencies to the stigma of the pistil. This is termed as pollination. The pollen grain germinate on the stigma and the resulting pollen tube grow through the tissue of stigma and style and reach the ovule. The pollen tube enter the embryo sac where the two male gametes are discharged. One of the male gamete fuses with the egg cells in gamete to form the zygote. The other male gamete fuses with the diploid secondary nucleus to form the triploid primary endosperm nucleus, PEN. Because of the occurrence of two fusions, that is syngamy and triple fusion, this event is termed as double fertilization, an event unique to angiosperms. The zygote develops into an embryo with one or two cotyledons, and the PEN develops into endosperm, which provide nourishment to the developing embryo. The synergids and antipodal degenerate after fertilization. During these events, the ovule develop into seed and the ovaries develop into fruit. The life cycle of an angiosperm is shown in the figure 3.6. 3.6. Plant life cycle and alternation of generations. In plant, both haploid and diploid cells can divide by mitosis. This ability leads to the formation of different plant bodies, haploid and diploid. The haploid plant body produces gametes by mitosis. This plant body represents a gametophyte. Following fertilization, the zygote also develops by mitosis to produce a diploid sporophytic plant body. Haploid spores are produced by this plant body by meiosis. These in turn divide by mitosis to form a haploid plant body once again. Thus, during the life cycle of any sexually reproducing plant, there is an alternation of generation between gamete-producing haploid gametophyte and spore-producing diploid sporophyte. However, different plant groups as well as individuals representing them differ in the following patterns. First, sporophytic generation is represented only by one cell zygote. There are no free-living sporophytes. Meiosis in the zygote result in the formation of haploid spores. These haploid spores divide mitotically and form the gametophytes. The dominant photosynthetic phase in such plant is the free-living gametophyte. This kind of life cycle is termed as haplontic. Many algae such as Wallbox, Pyrogyra and some other species of Chlamydomonas represent this pattern. Figure 3.7a. Second, on the other extreme is the type wherein the diploid sporophyte is the dominant photosynthetic independent phase of the plant. The gametophytic phase is represented by the single to few cell haploid gametophyte.
This kind of life cycle is termed as diplontic. An algae Fucus species represent this pattern, figure 3.7b. In addition, all seed-bearing plants, that is gymnosperms and angiosperms, follow this pattern with some variation within wherein the gametophytic phase is few to multicelled. Third, bryophyte and pteridophyte interestingly exhibit an intermediate condition, haplodiplontic. Both phases are multicellular, however they differ in their dominant phases. A dominant independent photosynthetic thalloid or erect phase is represented by the haploid gametophyte, and it alternates with the short-lived multicellular sporophyte, totally or partially dependent on the gametophyte for its anchorage and nutrition. All bryophytes represent this pattern. The diploid sporophyte is represented by the dominant independent photosynthetic vascular plant body. It alternates with multicellular sporophytic autotrophic saprophytic autotrophic independent but short-lived haploid gametophyte. Such a pattern is known as haplodiplontic life cycle. All pteridophytes exhibit this pattern. Figure 3.7c. Interestingly, while most algal genera are haplontic, some of them such as Ectocarpus, Polysiphonia, Kelps are haplodiplontic. Fucus, an alga, is diplontic.